Man, they are cool. They're really cool. They look prehistoric.
A 7-foot fish has got a pretty strong whack with his tail.
But the cool thing about it is that they're overall a pretty docile creature.
Obviously, we have to watch out for the teeth.
You won't see them outwardly snapping at you, trying to get at you with the teeth. They're just thrashing around like any fish would if you put them in the bottom of the boat.
Historically, alligator gar have been considered both by anglers and by managers as essentially the trash fish. No one really cared about them. No one really fished for them. So the managers didn't really spend time collecting data on them either.
Ready?
But things have changed, and this large, long-lived species has caught the angler's eye.
The increase in popularity obviously is putting greater pressure on our populations. Texas is home to the best populations of alligator gar left in the United States. And we want to keep them that way.
Thanks to funding from the Wildlife and Sport Fish Restoration Programs, biologists are now collecting data and tagging alligator gar so they can track them from year to year.
We know alligator gar can live longer than 50 years. They can get huge.
Alligator gar are the largest of the 4 species of gar in Texas. There's the spotted gar, long-nose gar, and short-nose gar as well. Documentation shows that alligator gar have weighed over 300 pounds and are a popular fish for anglers. While anglers can keep 1 alligator gar per day, catch and release is preferred.
All right, away he goes.
And so we're trying to collect as much information as we can to try to protect, conserve, manage, to ensure that the resource is available today, tomorrow, and 100 years from now.
Biologists have reason to care. A similar large species, the lake sturgeon in the Great Lakes, was commercially overfished to 1% of its historic abundance in the early 1900s. They're vulnerable because, like gar, it takes them years to reach reproductive maturity.
It takes a very long time for species with this type of life history to make a comeback when the populations become depleted. So we don't want to get in the situation where we have to react to over-harvest.
I've fished a lot, and I've never really fished for alligator gar. But I tell you what, after working with them, I would definitely fish for alligator gar. I would recommend anyone to do that.
For Texas Parks and Wildlife, this is Abe Moore.